same thing, cousin. I everybody wanna kill the king, like shit, wanna take the crown. I can see through it like a stomach with a other sign. When I hit the gas, I be going like 100 miles. They be getting tired, running out like a 100 house. All up in my business, real nose like a bloodhound.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Miami Dolphins. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Hey. First play from scrimmage, Stafford. He gets it left side to Johnson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards on the gain. A great start for this offense.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Hey, middle, middle, middle. 50, 50. Hey.
To throw is Stafford. Again, it's Johnson. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
So we just called his name on the previous snap, and they go right back to him, Charles, for a second consecutive completion.
Yeah, I think what we're discovering on this drive is that he feels like he has answers no matter what defense you throw up there. He reads it, finds the open spot, and is available for the completion.
Now a first down throw, Stafford. He's got his tight end, Freiermuth, right side. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
This defense for the Dolphins, they were very good a week ago in that win over Minnesota.
And while you can't actually see confidence rising in a unit, you feel like you can. And when you look at this team, you definitely think that it is, because anytime you can tell your offense, just get us a couple of touchdowns, we got this thing locked down, that's when you know you're playing well.
Throwing again is Stafford. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards.
Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And the top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
From the red zone now, Stafford. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Nice job there forcing that incompletion. This is going to be a fun battle throughout this game, watching him try to take away that area of the field.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Stafford. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
22!
Stafford looks to throw again. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'm guaranteed he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
On fourth down, Stafford. Open man is Johnson. Touchdown, Steelers. Deontay Johnson, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Steelers' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Looking to pass. Tua. On the screen, this is Edmonds. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
And that's not a play that you see all that often at the start of a drive, but some teams, they don't mind doing it. And that one, well sold by the offensive lineman. They showed the pass, and then they got out into space, able to get some good blocks downfield and allow the play to be successful.
Get ready.
Tua now on first down. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll be dropped just shy of the 35 at the 34. A pickup of 17 on a play that originated at the 17.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. The Dolphins at 500, 3-3 through the season's first 6 weeks. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
That's a nice design there, but sometimes, though, you get so many blockers out ahead of you, they kind of slow you down and force you to adjust. You always appreciate guys trying to help you, but maybe one less there could have turned this into a bigger game.
The Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Got a man, it's Waddle complete. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 18. Give them 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. They'll run on first down, Edmonds. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Six nothing, our score after one.
Let's go now.
13 yards remaining on second down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field.
Here we go, set.
Edmonds running out of the shotgun, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Oftentimes when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
Hey, green.
On second and 12, Tua over the middle. He's got Gesicki, the big 6'5 tight end.
Here we go.
This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Tua sets up to pass it. And able to find Gesicki as tight end. And the Dolphins are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
That's another Dolphins first down. First and goal at the 2 yard line.
Go, 38.
And they'll try the option on first and goal. And he's going to ball his way into the end zone for the Dolphins score. Tua Tagovailoa scoring on the 2 yard keeper. And the Dolphins have tied the ball game with a chance to take the lead. Footing always a concern, but the extra points up and good. And they take the lead here at 7-6. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Pulls it in at the 13.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Out of the gun, Stafford. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Stafford now to throw. And the catch made by Johnson. And he'll only get this to the 47. He needed a few more yards to pick up the first. Here we go on fourth. Stafford. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. Behind the chain, second and 13. From the gun, it's Tua. Quick hitter to Jalen. And a loose football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. They've got to find a good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy. When you run in the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available. And incompletion as a result.
Alert! 21 and 20.
Third and two, Stafford. Throw left side complete. That's Johnson. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Deontay Johnson with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Steelers have regained the lead. This time, the extra point up and good. And that'll make this a 6-point game. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Well, you don't see that often. He just mishit it, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, I know sitting up here, and I'm looking at you, and you're looking at me, and I know we're both thinking the same thing. Isn't it easy enough to keep it between the sidelines? Because unless you're intentionally doing it for some reason, well, that's a costly mishit, and now you put your team in a bad spot.
Watch out.
On first down, Tagovailoa. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. It'll be a gain of five, and it'll be second down.
A gain of five brings up second and five at the 45-yard line.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. That's out to the flat for Edmonds. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Ahead of the chains now, second and two. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 23. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. And it's caught. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the two. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Here's Tua. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. It's a loss of three on what should be the final play of the first half. Tua, the final shot before half. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Tyreek Hill. And the final seconds of the first half. And the Dolphins have tied the ball game with a chance to take the lead into the locker room. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that will give him the lead here as we get on towards halftime. So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. Fair catch called for and collected right at the 10-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. 1 second, all that remains. He sets to fire deep. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half it didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple...
Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach, and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one that he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
After the interception, here's Stafford. His throw incomplete.
That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call for second and long. What do you do? Run and try to get some yardage and make it third manageable? Or challenge the coverage again, hoping for a bigger gain?
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with a short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
Third down, Stafford. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now a first down throw, Stafford. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Matthew Stafford, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Steelers have retaken a third quarter lead.
So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they've turned that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Channing Tindall. A big seam, and he might go all the way. He's at the 40, 20, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
Here we go.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive.
This offense returning out there, and really, you remember the last drive, Charles, it was over before it even began. They threw the interception on the very first play.
And would that mean...
Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Akello Witherspoon. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown.
So that a real wrench thrown in now for this offense. They're trying to make a game of this in the third quarter, but that is not going to help.
Yeah, partner, probably should have used a different tool on that play, right? That ultimately is the kind of play where you could lose a ball game instead of being in a position to win.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. Down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Back to the air on second down, Tagovailoa. It's brought in by Wilson. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
It's a gain of 21 yards. And the Dolphins first down. First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Two and now on first down. Quick slant, Tyreek Hill with it. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant, a lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Looking to throw again on second down. Tua, a quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Wait, wait. No, no.
2-1 to throw again. They'll go out to the flat for Edmonds. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Well, they've been back on the heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Third quarter from Miami. This is second and 10.
Mike Blue.
Now Tua. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
And now offensively it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now the play caller's thinking, what have I done before this worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. On the screen, this is Edmonds. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Oh, we're always talking about the athleticism we see from these guys on the field. How about the intelligence as well? He recognized that there was a screen pass on that one, broke off his pass rush, and got back to tackle the running back. That's great scouting and great reaction.
Bill Green.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And the Steelers are going to take over here up near the 40.
Okay, partner. No surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. On first and 10, Stafford. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. So that changes things. You get the interception, and then to boot, a good return tacked on.
And really, it was down to him versus the quarterback on the return, and that's one you would think the defender would win. But a nice job there of seeing the play all the way to the end and making the tackle by the QB.
Running left, here's Edmonds. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I think this running game, or should I say lack of one, is making this defense look better than what they really are.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Looking to pass, Tua. Touchdown, Dolphins! A great play there. His first NFL reception goes for 6. And the Dolphins take the forced turnover on defense and convert it into 6 points. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is down to a field goal. touchdown to kick. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. From the 29, Stafford. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out of here and get the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line.
Well, nursing such a small lead, you thought he'd take better care of the football after his last drive. Now for the second straight possession, he's put all the pressure right back on his defense. They need to take a stand and hold that lead.
After the turnover, it's Tua.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete.
And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line.
Well, they've certainly had their share of troubles running the football in this one, but this play is almost an extension of the running game right here. They set up the screen, let him work out in space on the perimeter, and he turns it into a big pickup.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Tua sets up to pass it. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better, 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Tua setting up shop to throw again. Got a man. It's Waddle complete. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Monte Nicholson picks it, and the Steelers are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot, and if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there, and sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. On first down, Stafford here. Pass complete, George Pickens with it. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
22!
Stafford now to throw. He's got his tight end, Freiermuth, over the middle. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one goes for 24 yards.
These guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 42-yard line. Now Stafford. And that one going to come up short, low throw.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game. It has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
He gets this one to Johnson. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 26. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. 16 yards, a first down. Again, it's Stafford. A throw left side, caught by the tight end, Freiermuth. Down inside the 10, and in for the Steelers' touchdown. Pat Freiermuth, 26 yards. And the Steelers are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. Extra point put through by Boswell, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Tua, and he fires one incomplete.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
Here's Tua. He's got a complete to Waddle. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
It's a game of 20. And the Dolphins first down.
Tagovailoa. They'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Whether it's a touchdown or a field goal, whatever it is, they need to score quickly here on first down. Now Tua. Finding Waddle, crossing the field and bringing it in. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. 2 to throw. Caught on the slant. That's good for a gain of 6. Second and goal. Now Tagovailoa. Quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away. Passing lanes, tough to come by with so many defensive backs on the field here late in the game. And it's not just the number of bodies, it's their quickness and their agility that makes it tough to complete a pass.
Sanders' kick is good.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon here, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe to get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. It happened in the NFL. The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November. Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
And this is caught, and that could seal it. It's a touchdown. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
Boswell good with the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. You go to each other in practice, obviously your training camps, your offseason. But on game day, you both want to show your best. And I think that's what we saw from both the offense and the defense, a complete team victory.
So for the Steelers, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Philly to take on the Eagles. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, they fall a game under the 500 mark at 3-4 through seven games. And they'll look to